So, your uncle. What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, Detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first.
Looks abandoned.
It can't be. There has to be someone around.
Wait here. I'll go around back. Now, what do we got here? Nah, I'm not getting in there.
Hello, my name is Richard.
one big tree to fit inside a conservatory.
Every day, your silence weighs a little heavier. It's been a difficult year for everyone, and many have lost all hope. I read in the paper.
I need the key.
Please do not touch the boiler. It is working after.
That doesn't look safe. Okay.
Sunday, June 22nd. I spent all day.
The Great Depression. President Hoover raises tariffs on over 20,000 imported goods in an act to protect American labor. Following the collapse of the...
I need the key.
Thanks.
What are you doing? Who are you?
Whoa, pardon me. Excuse me. My name is Edward Carnby, private investigator. I hope you don't mind we let ourselves inside.
I do mind. This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. It's urgent, and no one was answering the door.
We can't hear you knocking anymore. None of us can.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right? She has that Hartwood gloom, doesn't she?
That's right. I'm Emily Hartwood. I just came to make sure my uncle is all right.
Well, he is unavailable right now. You will have to come back another day.
Unavailable? How? Is he sleeping? We can wait.
He's lost.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Who's your man again, Miss Hartwood?
My name's Edward Carnby, private investigator.
Splendid.
Enough, all of you. Get back to your rooms. McCarthy, keep your eyes on the child. And you two, please leave immediately.
Look, we're not here to cause any trouble. Just let us see the old man, satisfy the curiosity of my client here, and we'll be off.
Jeremy has gone missing. There's no need to worry, but it might be some time before he turns up. The whole staff is looking for him.
What? He ran off?
I don't have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
All right, in that case, we'll just wait in his room. You don't mind, do you? It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent. Thank you, madam. Here we are.
Let's look around. See if we can dig up any clues.
Anything important I should look out for? Did he keep a diary?
Not that I know of, but it wouldn't surprise me.
Every night the dark man stands opaque at the threshold of my room, counting the days until my spirit...
Hey, you know anything about this? Looks like some sort of talisman.
No, I don't. Oh, help me out here, will you?
Now, would it kill the guy to throw some of this stuff out? I'd be crazy, too, if I had this much junk lying around.
Striking. I want to save this one.
All right, come on. I want to go see Dr. Gray.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming. Miss Hartwood. Emily? going on? Where am I?
Christ, what the hell?
Can't go that way.
Don't let them get inside, compare. They're not the good guy.
Are you? Is this your store?
There are no owners here. We both strangers in Jeremy's store.
Jeremy did this? How?
The pact with the dog man. Jeremy warned us, but we didn't think much of it.
I'm Detective Edward Carnby. I was hired by Jeremy's niece to find him.
Oh, yeah? How much she paying you?
$150.
She's sure getting her money's worth tonight. You were thinking, man, compare.
Not if I can help it.
You know, I think Jeremy's hiding in a way we can't find him. He has this juju necklace that guides him.
The talisman?
That's right. It's some magic charm he got from Miss Jackson down the street.
The voodoo priestess?
You know surprising things, compare. Yeah, the Mama Loa. Here, take the key. I locked the gate to save her place from all the ghouls and goblins getting inside. Maybe if you go there, you can find some clues to show you the way.
Thanks. I'll have a look. You want to come along?
Nah, I'm gonna stay here for a while.
Talisman, like the one in the painting. I think it's meant for the talisman. I think it needs numbers, like coordinates. Maybe there's something in Jeremy's notes. It's showing something. A place? Where is that? Huh.
Detective, I was wondering when you were going to show up. Mrs. Thompson told me you were here. I understand you are working for Jeremy Hartwood's niece.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you're not wrong. We came here for her uncle. I didn't expect this. You are Dr. Gray, right?
That's right. You don't happen to have some identification, Detective. I'm not keen on having strangers prying into my business. Oh, Detective Edward Carnby, Decatur Street, New Orleans. Enjoying the Vieux Carré, Detective? Those old French quarters, the voodoo people, the gangsters. I'm sure you live an exciting life.
Well, that's not quite like the stories, Doc. Just trying to make a living.
Aren't we all making a living? Well, welcome to DeSeto, Detective. I hope your time here will be useful. Now, what can I do for you?
Why don't you tell me where I can find Jeremy Hartwood?
Why wouldn't that make for a short visit? I wish I could tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know. A drink, Detective?
Anything brandy.
Oh, You do belong in the French quarters, Detective. Armagnac or cognac?
You know, just give me the cheap stuff. I'm not much of a connoisseur.
Having low standards is not a virtue, Detective. Let me see if I can broaden your perspective.
What can you tell me about Jeremy?
I wouldn't want to go into details about his condition. Doctor-patient confidentiality. I'm sure you understand.
Sure. But he is crazy. And he's gone missing. Why?
Here. Try this.
Ooh, it's good. Got a bite?
It's called a sidecar. The trick is not to be afraid of the tartness of the lemon. Then, for goodness sake, don't overdo the triple sec.
Okay, what can you tell me about Jeremy?
Well, let me think. He is an anxious man, constantly worried about events not presenting themselves according to his model of predestination. He complains about things not being carried out in the right order, and that some things simply shouldn't be. Is any of this helpful to you?
Not really. I was hoping for some direction where to look next.
I'm sorry. I have nothing for you then. You should talk to my orderlies. They have been looking for him for a while now. I'm sure they would appreciate your help.
Yeah, I ran into Baptiste earlier. Come to think of it, he might have given me a lead.
Oh, excellent. So your investigation is already underway.
I'm gonna go, but I'm sure we'll meet again.
Looking forward to it. Safe returns.
Detective Carnby, how did you... Where did you go?
I was just talking to Dr. Gray.
You disappeared?
No, it's not what you think. Have you found anything strange going on here?
Yes. Everyone is being incredibly evasive and I can't figure out why.
No, I mean something you can't explain. Paranormal, even.
Detective, I really need you to get yourself together. I can't do this alone.
Forget it. I'll figure it out.
Do you want to come see Dr. Gray?
No. I want to try something. With this talisman, I think I can follow Jeremy to the place he mentioned in the book. What was the name? Do you remember something Spanish? Tarawea. Yeah, that's where I need to go.
Detective, are you going to be all right?
Yeah, of course. Go talk to Dr. Gray. We'll rendezvous later.
This talisman brought me back from the French Quarter in the blink of an eye. Jeremy can travel so easily, and he could be hiding anywhere, even Tarawea. If he can do it, so can I. I just need to figure out how...
Saw your notice in the boiler room. You should know Mr. Chance.
The talisman works.
Paul, you're right about the plates on the boiler and the clock. They have been sabotaged, and I think I know...
Dr. Elmore Lee Gray is DeSeto's chief doctor.
I need the key. I need the key.
All the patients are accounted for. There's no way I can get into this thing. Better leave it alone.
This must be the...
Looks like the plate that held the talisman in the seance room. But it's...
Sorry, detective. Didn't mean to obstruct justice or anything.
That's fine.
You know, I'm kind of busy with my own case of a missing person. I was wondering if you've seen Grace, a girl about yay high?
I can't say that I have. Why are you asking?
Well, I'm looking for her.
Is she in trouble?
No. She's just hiding somewhere. But we can't have a rascal like that running around unchecked at a time like this, you understand?
Well, I haven't seen her.
Well, let me know if you find her. I'll be around. I'll keep an eye out for your man, Jeremy. You scratch my back, detective, and I'll scratch yours.
Looks like everything's back to normal here.
Emily's here.
Eccentric.
I did it. I crossed the thresholds to my intended destiny.
Well, I need to remember how to get them out again.
What are these symbols? Looks like alchemy or star constellations. Got some grim-looking rot on them. Astarte Artist Colony. I remember hearing about their disappearance. Must have been 15 years or more now. Thank you.
What happened? Everything's...
I need the key.
Detective Conby had a hard time understanding.
Lost Plantations of Louisiana, Thierry Bricklow, 1917. Derceto was a small plantation on the eastern shore of Lake Pontchartrain.
Wedge shut. Now we're talking. Huh. think I've seen this somewhere. Something in the commonplace book about this. I think the clock broke. Or maybe it just stopped at a very precise place. Picture in the black glass. It's showing me something. It's the hallway outside Jeremy's room. Entered another one of Jeremy's memories. Ugh.
May 1923, Monday. All okay. Ready for delivery.
Huh. I need the key. locked.
Got it.
Ah! pretty weak. I just need something to break it.
Gotta be a way to get to the other side.
Oh.
All right. Now what? The hateful mound Jeremy talked about in his book.
Don't come any closer. I'm armed.
Get that thing out of my face.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm just a detective trying to find something called Tarawea.
You're after Jeremy too? Why?
I'm working for his niece. She wants to make sure he's all right.
He might be unharmed, but far from all right. He's a curse upon DeSeto.
Here we go again.
Quiet!
Reflections on the power of the verb in certain texts.
It's wedged shut.
It worked.
The Barlow lens. Instructions.
I think I have everything I need.
It was a...
key. There's something missing. This must be that kid's room.
Don't you worry, Grace. Go play your game.
Why does she seem so familiar? Out there. You drawing something?
Nothing special. I'm just bored.
Do I know you from somewhere?
I remember you, Mr. Conby.
From where?
Don't touch that. Cassandra wouldn't like it. She wouldn't like it at all.
Do you know where she is?
I'd rather not talk about it. It makes me upset. Besides, she'll be back after the Feast of St. John.
You think?
Yep. It's all on the page, Mr. Conby. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt.
All right.
I'm gonna go now, if that's okay. I don't like to stay too long in the same place. Mr. McCarthy might find me.
Hey. Is he mean to you?
Not everyone needs to be saved, Mr. Conby. You should know that by now.
Miss Beauregard. I picked up your medicine at the post.
So this is where Cassandra... It's another one of those strange padlocks. There's more of that rot again. Like it's guiding me to do something. But what? If I find the full set of bottles, then maybe I can make something out of the stains of rot.
The medicine bottles had stains of rot.
You know, Mr. Waits, I saw a piece of the plate that Liza broke.
It's stained. Looks like some kind of rot. It worked. Jeremy? What the hell is going on here? Where's the body? It's another plate for the talisman. Like the other one, it's broken and missing some pieces.
Kitchen. I assure you.
I'm sorry.
I promise you, Mr. Hartwood is nowhere near my kitchen, and neither should you be. Don't make me kick you out of this house.
Sorry.
Now get out!
Wedge shut. It worked.
Detective Conby. How good of you to come. Let me pour you a drink.
What happened here? This place looks like it was hit by a bomb.
Welcome to the madhouse, Detective.
Thanks. Did the ceiling just collapse?
I heard it was something in the attic. Something that was supposed to happen, but didn't. How that could have such consequences is beyond me. The truth is, I don't know why the room looks like this. But I bet your friend Jeremy does.
You know where I could find him?
Oh, somewhere in his past, I suppose. He keeps going on about that mysterious dark man. I think he is hiding from him. Or maybe he's with him. I can't really keep up. I don't worry much. Take a look around this room. You may think it looks spectacularly devastated, but I just think it's finally found its stride. It fits perfectly with the state of this place and its loonies. The same goes for the nonsense with Jeremy. In my eyes, we finally managed to match the wild ride inside all of us.
Well, I'm happy you find the evening so harmonious. I hope you don't mind me setting things right. Jeremy's business, that is. This room looks beyond my capabilities.
Good luck, Detective. Hope to see you again soon.
Yeah. Evening, miss.
On the common place of evil.
More of that aggressive rot.
black glass is showing another room. Must be a way to another one of Jeremy's memories.
I knew it would work. You're getting good at this, Carnby. Maybe a little too good at this. Hartwood's family crypt. Emily's family must have deeper roots in New Orleans than I thought. I figured she was a Yankee like me. There's something missing. What's this? Sketched this chapel in his book, so it must be important. Looks like I'll need more medallions to open it, though.
It's blocked.
Please don't touch her.
Jeremy. What are you doing here? Everyone's looking for you.
I know. It's all a big mess. No one understands. I'm just trying to keep evil at bay. Just for a little while longer.
You've got to come back with me. Your niece is waiting at Dorsetto.
Emily? Why would you... My letter. You keep making it worse.
What is going on, Jeremy? How is any of this happening?
I made a terrible promise with someone.
The Dark Man. Who is he?
No, don't say his name. He can hear us.
He's always listening. Jeremy, I need to understand what is going on.
I promised him everything. When the sun rises, I will be chained in his sunken desert temple for an eternity. But at least the evil about to awaken in DeSetto won't harm anyone outside of that cursed place.
You're acting crazy, Jeremy. I want to help.
There's nothing you can do.
Then what's all the business about Tarawea? Why did you want to go there?
Well, I can't go there. Not allowed.
But you wanted to. Can I go? Tell me, will it help me to break your pact? Is there something there that would help?
Why would you give me hope? That's so cruel.
Okay. Sounds like we're onto something here. What should I-
Look out! Behind you! Run! Don't let it take you! I've seen so many strange occurrences lately. Memories explode.
She's dead. No matter how she died, she looks peaceful now. Telescope lens. Why would he lock that up? Need the key. Whoa, what's going on? It's dialing in something all on its own and it's showing the way to another memory? Where is that? Here we go.
I'm glad to see you made it. I had my doubts, but the hope you instilled has yet abandoned me.
I guess this must be Tarawea. Who are you?
My name is Juan Luis Jorge, and this is indeed the convent of Tarawea. You'll have to excuse me, but Yermi never got your name.
The name's Edward Carnby. I'm a private investigator. You're not a patient, are you?
No. I'm the author of a book that Yermi once found important.
How does that work? Are you part of this memory as well? Is this even a memory?
I think calling me a manifestation of Yermi's subconscious would be more correct. And so is the convent of Tarawea. I'm a man Yermi has never met. And we are in a place that he has never been.
Okay. So are you here to guide me or something?
I have no more purpose than you do. I simply am. I will happily help you, of course, if I'm able.
If you are already somehow part of Jeremy, why did he want to come here? Isn't he sort of here already?
Yermi wanted to come here because it's a representation of his mind at peace. When Dr. Gray asks him to find his focus during his sessions, this far-flung convent is what Yermi imagines. He is under the impression that if he could physically come here, he would reach a perfect equanimity. A spiritual apotheosis.
You don't think it would work?
Yermi subconsciously knows it's just wishful thinking. He can't come here. Despite the pathways opened by the dark man between Derceto and Yermi's psyche, it's simply not possible.
But I'm here.
Indeed. It's a shame it's just another place for you, Detective. Otherwise, you could have become a Buddha.
Always a bridesmaid, never a blushing bride. Am I right?
Yes, I suppose so. You'll have to chase enlightenment elsewhere.
So what's the next best thing? What can I do here?
You should seek out the convent library and try to find the truth about Yermi's relationship with the Dark Man. It's the sort of knowledge he represses and is unable to reflect on.
Will it tell me how to break the pact?
Perhaps. At least you'll have something to confront Yermi with.
Wait, why can't you just tell me?
I don't know such things. You'd be better off consulting the texts of Dr. Freud, if you want such answers.
No thanks, I hate shrinks.
There is another thing you should know about the library. He is here as well. The Dark Man has been working his way through the texts for a long, long time.
He's here? How am I supposed to get past him?
Be careful, Detective.
Oh, jeez. Just perfect. There's something missing.
The great library was endless, beautiful. Thank you.
It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution. Hey.
Detective!
Juan! Juan!
I hope you found what you were looking for. I fear there is no going back.
I was so close. There must be something I can work with. Come on, Garmby, think! Think! Shipping company. Prext. Right.
Good luck, detective.
Well, thank God you're here, detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this. I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey. Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon. Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carnby.
Enchanté.
Are you sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise to the dark man.
Yeah. Do you know anything about that kind of stuff?
No. But it makes you wonder. If he made a promise, can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of a bad deal, so he'll come back with us to New Orleans.
Well, if all fails.
What are you doing?
It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in a dream once.
What? You don't know the Prext Shipping Company by any chance?
I do. They made big money during the war. But their waterfront office is just over there.
How did you do that?
Do what, Detective? Bonne chance.
Hey, have you seen Emily Hartwood anywhere?
Are you trying to make me jealous, Detective? No, I haven't seen your doll anywhere.
Shipping Company. According to the book in Tarawea, the Dark Man is connected to a performance that Jeremy went to somewhere in New Orleans. I'm sure I can find the address inside.
It's locked from the other side.
sewer system has a tunnel running right below Preg's shipping company. I bet I can use it to get inside. The sewer system has a tunnel running right below Preg's shipping company. I bet I can use it to get inside. No way I can get this out of the way with my bare hands. But if I get that crane going, that should do it.
made it inside the warehouse. The office must be upstairs.
Hey, I always wanted to try one of these.
Our ship was raided while in dock. All of his things were recovered.
Here we go. The address where Jeremy first encountered the Dark Man. Looks like the fog cleared up. You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, Detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nyarlathotep, the Black Pharaoh, the ancient magician who lived a thousand lives and wore a thousand masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So, you got scared by a stage magician. And now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, Detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we?
You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No, we can't. We were trying to loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. He offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't. I have to make this sacrifice.
God damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry. How do you save someone who doesn't want to be saved? Well, he's gonna get saved no matter what. I just need to find the temple somehow.
The address of...
The temple of Nefrenkar lies under our camp. Despite all efforts, that unholy...
Sunken desert temple. It's the star constellation from one of Jeremy's books. But I got a feeling this is it. This is where the contract is hidden. But how do I get to it?
This one looks operational. Good work. Thank you.
collapse.
Acknowledge psychological trauma, breakthrough barriers of self-deceit, tempermanic behavior. These are the Dark Man's terms. The contract. Huh?
What are you doing?
I found something.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Dorsetto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well, just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Dorsetto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... Where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck.
Ah! Ah!
I worry, Detective.
Don't, I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Trust me, you're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that Detective Bella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Combi seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
Thank you.
was that?
The two orderlies still hadn't found...
It's blocked. There must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office in here somewhere. I don't have a combination for this.
Detective Conby, good to see you again. Solved the case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something is different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
These. Wouldn't want them to get lost. The combination. I carry it with me. I know that number. Where's that from? I did this. I wrote that. key. It worked.
The last guest in the empty room.
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can figure this guy out.
Dearest Dr. Manzetti, I find myself in a losing battle with my patient. As I've disclosed...
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young. It's very...
Take this much more. This has to end.
Radiography, patient Jeremy Hartwood. Hypothetical psychosurgery based on the...
mind if I do. That's better. Need the key.
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do?
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place. Jeremy's hiding, right?
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking me.
Jeremy, where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running.
boat's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river. By electricity. I need to find a way to turn it on before I can use it.
I'm all out of bullets.
Pretty weak. This definitely needs fuel.
Wolf!
Are you ready to tell me what happened in the island?
I put a rope around my neck, and then I strangled all life from my body.
Are you under the impression?
No. I was supposed to die.
What does that mean? That you were supposed to die.
I'm the catalyst. I had to die to make the story happen.
What are you referring to, Jeremy?
30 years ago, Frederic needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in
place. Hey! I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Conby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
That was Jeremy's self-deceit? A steamboat stuck in the mud? I'm not going to pretend I understand any of that.
Jeremy was calling out for help, but Conby couldn't fit.
What a bunch of psychoanalytic nonsense.
I have finished tidying up Miss Beauregard's belongings.
Something missing. I can't leave. I got a job to do. Where's that from? Yes. I know that I wrote that.
Detective, I have made many.
How long have I been here? Surprisingly neat. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short.
Sometime.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here?
This looks familiar. How am I back at the off? I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. That's me, isn't it? How long has it been since I drowned myself? Drinking depression. And it all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark void. Wrapped around my mind like a heavy blanket. It turned off suddenly as I woke up from the sound of my office door closing shut. A messenger had left a telegram for Mrs. Saunders. She had a lead on where to find her husband and her kidnapped daughter. God, I used to drink so much back then. I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state.
But he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so. Thornhill wasn't a bad man, but he had principles keeping him from handing out information about his deals. So it needed some convincing. Well, every case can't be squeaky clean. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all. But I can't say it didn't happen. On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money, a lot of it. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed.
I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. It was a stupid move. They'd be back. I found him. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting and the signature. Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room.
Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. This room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them, but where?
That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge. Pearl River? This is where I caught up with him. This is what the dark man wanted me to revisit. But I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting?
I can't believe I didn't recognize you.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just... so much is happening. I can't... I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean... I am sorry. I don't think I need to begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. It's what the Dark Man wants.
I guess we just watched my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself. I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes. There was a boat at the house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car. This must be where the bridge is operated. Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
Bullet.
Conby had run their...
Carnby, are you okay?
Don't leave me alone.
What the hell have you been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place? It's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Dracetto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain... things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily, don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
can't leave. I got a job to do. It's blocked.
What was happening? It was funny when all the blood started coming.
The girl you brought.
What is that?
Mrs. Thompson, I understand the last week has been busy.
I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them.
Detective, am I glad to see you. Lock the door, will you? I don't think Dr. Gray would appreciate us snooping around.
What's going on here? This feels so strange. There's a book missing.
What did you do?
I was just rearranging the books.
Well, come on, let's check it out. I think I'm beginning to understand. Dr. Gray is dealing with some kind of mass delusion.
Has that been there this whole time?
Good to finally meet you, Mr. Hartwood. I'm here on the behalf of your brother, Philip. You were expecting me. Weren't you?
That mark on the floor looks like talisman positions. But from which direction should I look at it?
The Snake Dagger, a monograph by Yael Klein. In Ludwig Prinz's book on...
Hello?
Detective Carnby?
Who is this? Jeremy?
Jeremy is with the Dark Man. You can't save him.
Well, I've done everything he wanted so far, and there's just one more thing on the list. I expect him to keep his promise and return Jeremy unharmed.
Get out, Detective. While you still can.
You okay? You look a little frazzled.
Just stupid telephone.
I know. I tried calling the police earlier. The telephone is completely dead.
It's not... Yeah, no, the telephone isn't working. Miss Hartwood, I think you're gonna want to see this.
Is there something in the closet?
Yeah, there is. You don't see the very obvious gate leading to whatever Jeremy's madness is serving up next?
I don't understand. Are you making some kind of fashion metaphor? I'm sorry, I don't have time for this. Can you just tell me what you're doing?
You don't see this! It's fine. It's fine. Catch you later.
Are you going inside the closet?
Yeah. You got a problem with that?
No. Do what you think is right, Detective.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. Goodbye, Miss Hartwood.
Hey, you! What are you doing here? What is this place?
Turn back, detective. You're not wanted here.
Whoa, take it easy. I'm not your enemy.
Oh, you're wrong, detective. You're wrong.
Aligned, Jeremy, or maybe that is what you need to temper that mania of yours.
Everything! Aren't you happy? Stupid charlatan. What more do you want from me? You want me to lose my mind?
Oh, my love! Doctor! Baptiste! Quick!
Jesus. What are you thinking, compadre?
Awake? You are awake. Mr. Conby's up.
Hey, buddy. I thought you'd be knocked out for the rest of the night. Come on out and join us, will you? I'll save you some gumbo.
Good to have you back. You gave us all a good scare.
What happened?
You had a psychological breakdown. Sorry for manhandling you, but you're being violent.
You stabbed Jeremy, and then punched Dr. Gray.
Are they okay?
Jeremy's a little strange, but everything's back to normal.
Really?
All thanks to you, Compat. You want to try standing up?
Well, if it isn't the hero of the day. How are you feeling, Detective?
Never better. How about you two? Hey, Jeremy, I didn't do too much damage, did I?
Things are fine. Very quiet.
What's up with him? Painkillers?
No. You see, despite you having the finesse of a one-eyed butcher, you managed to lobotomize dear Jeremy.
I did what?
It's actually quite impressive. It's not like I hadn't considered it myself. I just wish Jeremy could have been helped without reducing his personality to that of an oyster.
But he's gonna live.
Of course. As long as someone keeps feeding him, he'll outlive the best of us.
Everyone knows what to do. Y'all know the new words.
Mrs. Thompson, we talked about this. I'm not sure everyone is comfortable.
Doctor, I insist. This is important. We've waited for so long, Doctor.
Let's just go with the old song. Not every change is an improvement.
Boss, good or bad, you need to move forward.
All in, Doc. Let's bet it all.
But we don't know what we're dealing with.
It'll be okay, Doctor. Better even.
Now are there praises in abundance to the black goat of the woods. Hear us, brother. Take pity on us. Take pity on us.
Stop! Are you crazy?
This year still needs to happen, Carl.
Grace! Stop!
Yeah! Oh. Yeah. The ground! Yeah! Shoot the ground! The black goat of the woods!
Stop in the ground! Yeah!
Detective, get my uncle out of here!
Jeremy, come with me. Get over here. Jeremy, come with me. Jeremy, come here.
No, there has to be a sacrifice.
It's doomed.
I can't let that monster leave Dersetto. I have to stop it.
Detective. Oh,
what the hell was that?
I try to tell you. There was so much evidence. Their devotion to the Black Goat was like nothing I've ever seen before. I felt so dumb believing any of it, but I'm glad I did.
Are you okay?
Everything is out of order. This isn't the way the story goes. I shouldn't be alive.
Yeah. Well, you're welcome, buddy.
How are you doing, sweetie?
I kind of like it. You ruined everything, but I'm not mad.
All right, you ready to head back to New Orleans?
Come on, Jeremy. We're leaving.
Can I come?
I thought you said you didn't need saving.
Don't leave her. She's important.
Of course we're taking her with us.